In this video, we're going to take a look at how you can determine whether an element belongs to a system family or a loadable family. This is important because it determines how the family can be modified and where it can be modified. System families are defined within a Revit project, whereas loadable families are defined in external .rfa family files that can be opened in the Revit Family Editor. In this exercise file, I have some architecture elements, some structure elements, and some MEP elements. In my opinion, when you are just getting started with Revit, the easiest way to tell if an element belongs to a loadable family is to select it. For example, I'll select a window, and then take a look in the contextual ribbon and look for the Edit Family tool. If you see Edit Family, then that will tell you that that is a loadable family, because clicking Edit Family will open the family in the Family Editor. So as you can see here, when I clicked Edit Family, it opens in the Family Editor, and the ribbons are different and all the tools are different, and this is the Family Editor. You can then load it into the project, hence it's a loadable family. I'm going to close this window family, and now I'll select a wall. And a wall is a system family, but if you didn't know that, you could select it and look for the Edit Family tool. And as you can see, it does not appear. There are other options, but Edit Family does not appear. Similarly, if I select a floor, Edit Family does not appear. If I select a door, Edit Family does appear. So after working in Revit for just probably a few weeks, you'll start to understand which family categories are loadable families, made up of loadable families, and which ones are made up of system families. So with elements like walls, which belong to system families, those are defined within Revit, and particularly the Type Properties dialog. So when you click Edit Type, it opens the Type Properties dialog, and there are built-in controls to create family types. And with these compound families, like walls, floors, roofs, they're made up of various layers, and so you can adjust the structure of those elements. All right, let's take a look at some structure components here. So I'll select a column, and the Edit Family tool is available. Now, structure elements can be a little bit deceiving because if you look at kind of what system families are and what loadable families are, you would kind of think that structural columns and structural beams would be system families, but they're actually loadable families. And once again, you can tell that by selecting one of the elements and looking for Edit Family here in the contextual ribbon. If we go to some MEP elements, I'll select a duct. And once again, there's no Edit Family tool. Whereas if I select an air terminal, Edit Family is available. And then I'll select a duct fitting, and you can see Edit Family is available. Now, a typical rule of thumb is that if you were to go to a construction site and take a look at some of the components or objects there on the site, the elements that are constructed on the site are typically system families. And so those are things like floors, walls, roofs, ductwork, piping. Now, once again, that analogy can break down a bit because it's things with like prefab, some of those things are constructed offsite and then shipped to the site. But kind of as a rule of thumb, that's what you can use. And then the objects that would be ordered and shipped to the site, those are loadable families. And so things like plumbing fixtures, air terminals, lighting fixtures, doors, windows, those are loadable families. And then once again, some of the structural elements can be deceiving, such as columns and beams. You would typically think of those as system families with that analogy I just gave, but once again, analogies aren't perfect and they break down at a certain point. But as you use Revit, you'll become familiar with which categories of elements are made up of system families and which ones are loadable families. Lastly, I should also mention in-place. In-place families aren't used much, but I have this little extrusion back here. And when I select it, you can see Edit in-place appears in the contextual ribbon. So if you do see Edit in place, then you know that it is an in-place family. My suggestion is that you should not use in-place families unless it just absolutely makes sense. And so that way you don't end up with a bunch of in-place families that are basically just used and unique to that one project. But sometimes they are needed. And that's how you can tell if you do have an in-place family. All right, so that's how you can tell whether elements belong to a system family, a loadable family, or an in-place family.
Howdy, thanks for watching. If you'd like more free content from Click to BIM, please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We also have affordable subscription options at click2bim.com, where you can access all of our videos. We also have an amazing search feature that allows you to search through every single word in all of our videos to help you quickly find the answers to your questions.